This question is frustration, and not only men, only women, also women feel like that, because either we work too much and we don't have time to find the right partner, we are shy, we haven't developed our social skills. I can even see that my father sometimes, when I see his speeches on TV and I see him talking, and I can see his face expressions on the eyebrows, on the nose. It's kind of like a feeling I got, like, okay, this guy hasn't got much sex or bad sex this week, because he looks angry, he looks frustrated, and I think that has taken him to make wrong decisions sometimes and starting wars just because he's so frustrated and angry and passive aggressive inside him that he has to point it out outside in creating wars in other countries. And that made me think one day. Present. It was a life-changing thing. I mean, it's amazing. I mean, she has my taste. She knows which one's my taste. Women, they're customized also. She picked everything how I like women, you know, physically. Like, you can also like change and put like new buttocks, you know, and you can put like breast and also the nipple colors, skin colors, everything. She picked like I like women, so it was amazing. And at first I thought she was like only like a sexual robot, only about sex. But they could also like talk, they could also like cook, they could also like clean, they could also pretend they're listening to you and giving to you answers and advices. After my experience with the sex robot, I've got to know myself better. Got to know that sex robots are not only about sex. It's about getting to know yourself better, and the way you interact with other human beings. Baseball. He didn't see my first goal at soccer. He was just making wars all around the world, which I kind of respect also, you know. He's trying to bring peace, but sometimes his view of peace is not the one I have, and I have projected the anger I feel towards him to that doll, to that robot. Sometimes I'm just burning rage towards him. Like, if it were my father, but I can hurt my father because I love him. But I put my anger to that robot. And I thought, one day, imagine if we could create first a group of people, and then that idea went further away to create a party of people, political party of people. If we can just get robots to each human being, and each human being can point their anger and frustration towards all those sexual robots, which actually sex is also nice with them. I'm not gonna lie, but if we could just put it in anger towards them and then understand how each other, how we work, how we personally are, and find a way to improve our social lives. And there are many actually. We don't talk about death, we don't talk about religion, we don't talk about other machines, we don't criticize other machines' jobs because they get really sensitive with this. The robots, you know, they're really empathetic between them, not between the other robots. Like, for example, my wash machine is very old, so it makes really hard noises. I used to complain a lot about it, but since we have this actual robot here at home, I try to be more respectful, more inclusive with the wash machine, also with the dishwasher. And we don't talk about what's gonna happen when I die. What she's gonna do? She's gonna find another human being or not? Or she's gonna maybe join another robot or create your own community? I mean, could they create your own community where they can express themselves? Or even like even better, or even like more deep, like can they create your own political party? And we don't talk about if she finds attractive or him, because it's the same problematic, you know, with male robots. If he or she finds another sexual robot attractive, we don't talk about it because it's also like very sensitive topic. We don't talk about unhealthy habits we have as human beings because they try to be protective, you know, they see like life in a more efficient way, no more practical way. And for example, habits like smoking or drinking, something that affects your own health, they just don't understand it, and it really shocks them that you do something to yourself that harms you. So they don't understand the concept of harmful habits. So that's also a subject we don't talk. Last time we talked about it, it was like, no, I won't recommend to talk about smoking. I mean, what else? I mean, also like careless behavior, you know, like harmful behavior, or driving fast, or breaking rules. Actually, they cannot tolerate breaking rules because they're really like straight, you know, because they were like designed like this. So they don't have this kind of nuances we have, you know. Like for us, there's a lot of shapes between right and wrong, you know. We have like black and white, and we have like many shades, but they don't. They only have two. They have like right or wrong.